Now on BBC Two, we're flying away to the sunshine of Barbados for highlights of the day's cricket play against the West Indies.
Nice to have finished on a much brighter note than I did. My last 2 hours of the England captaincy was one of 7 wickets gone in brief time and us losing a match. That's never the way you want to go out.
After the shock of losing their captain, the England team have returned to the beautiful island of Barbados to begin their campaign in the One Day Internationals. After his success in Sharjah, the selectors have turned once again to Adam Holyoake to lead the England side. A week's a long time in international cricket, and Holyoake appreciates the twists and turns that this game can take.
One minute you're not playing, you're carrying out drinks and trying to think how you're going to get a game, and then the next minute, you're captain of your country. It's a great honour.
Welcome to Kensington Oval, Barbados. I'm Pat Murphy, bringing you highlights of the first in the one-day series between West Indies and England. England may have lost the Test 3-1, but they're on a bit of a one-day roll. They won the last 7 in a row, including the Sharjah Trophy last December. Now, in the modern hurly-burly of international cricket, players come and go. After the Test series, 6 have flown home to England, and another 6 have been drafted in. But before we check the exact team, let's join Michael Holding for his pitch report.
Thanks, Pat. Well, this pitch is exactly what you're hoping to find for a one-day international. If you take a good look at the surface, you will see that there's absolutely no grass on the surface. A bit has been rolled in, but the grass is brown because it has been pressed into the surface. It is dry, it is hard, the ball should come onto the bat. That is what you want. You want the bat to defeat the ball in these one-day games. And although the new ball might do a bit, it should be lots of runs in this pitch. Let's hope it's an interesting game.
Thanks, Michael. Well, Brian Lara won the toss for the West Indies. He decided to put England into bat. Quick look at the teams. England included 10 of the players who won the Sharjah Trophy in December. The only change, Ben Holyoake, who had a very good A-tour. He comes in for Ali Brown. As for West Indies, Stuart Williams, one of the openers, and Mervyn Dillon, one of the pace bowlers, miss out. We pick up action in the first over. Franklin Rose is bowling to Nick Knight, and 2 runs have been scored.
Nice looking stroke, it's beaten Chanderpaul. Short boundary down to the scoreboard. Good start for Nick Knight in England. Alex Stewart, big Chelsea Football Club supporter. I don't know who's number 4 for Chelsea, but he's number 4 for England for this series. Pulled away by Knight, there's a short boundary again. Through as well. Lambert's given up the chase already. I think this outfield is even quicker than it was for the Test match. Stewart hasn't got hold of that, but it's running away for 4 all the same.
Just too short. Certainly didn't time it very well, Alex Stewart. But it's a very, very quick outfield.
Really is in splendid condition, this Kensington Oval outfield. That's through again. These fielding restrictions certainly have changed the complexion of the one-day game. Nothing much Lara can do about this apart from risking doing without either third man or long leg.
Tremendous blow. That goes all the way. That is a tremendous blow by Nick Knight. He's been in very good form, from all reports, in the practice matches here in Barbados preceding the one-day series.
Well, it's barely short. He's onto it so quickly, Nick Knight. And hammers it away over mid-wicket. There you go. You don't see many better shots than that today.
That'll go away as well. So Rose now is proving expensive after that over that cost Walsh just the one run. Nick Knight has picked it back up here with a 6 and a 4.
Well, Franklin Rose will be a little disappointed. It's a good ball. It's length outside off stump. A good comeback after being hit out of the ground. Cost him 4 more runs.
That's really the first ball we've seen beat the bat. We're into the 10th over.
This will be a lot of help or assistance for quicker bowlers.
Lovely blow through the offside, and that's all you can describe it as, a blow. Really hammered that away. Really is a magnificent batting pitcher. Another boundary for England. They move on to 46 for that last after 10. Easy as that. So the 50 has been raised. Don't get there. Courtney Walsh on a deep backward square leg, really wasn't too far away from it. The ball sped across the outfield. Ambrose can get around. This outfield is very, very quick. I think we're looking really at a huge total here. Very good save. Clayton Lambert, oldest man in the field.
Tremendous piece of fielding. And that's what bowlers want in games like this, when they know that the odds are against them, the wicket's flat. When the fielders pull off saves like that, it really is a bonus.
Cracking shot. My goodness gracious. That has gone like a shot from a gun.
Really is a tremendous shot.
That's gone, big six. That raises his 50. Nick Knight in tremendous form. That's his second six.
Well, that's what happens if you bowl short. I don't think Nick Knight would mind Courtney Walsh. Once the ball bounces, I'm quite sure he's happy. It's a batsman's paradise. Short, and that is just powered away. And check this catch. That's not a bad effort there.
This is a very sensible move from Brian Lara. He's doing it the minute that he can change his field, i.e. with those fielding restrictions now lightened by the fact you can have 4 men outside the 30-yard ring rather than just 2.
It's a good bit of fielding.
Get the ball!
might have just been a chance. Difficult to tell. There was a shouted catch from Hooper. It was a terrific stop. Whether it was a catch or not.
Just a little bit of air. Oh, I think it might just have carried.
Wanting two, and shoddy work from the West Indies. Nobody backing up at either end has allowed England to go through for the overthrow.
That is high class. Great footwork from Nick Knight and great timing. Marvellous start by Nick Knight and Alex Stewart, and plenty of batting to come. Given that something, given it everything. Marvellous reactions from England's left-handed opener. It's a pleasure to see him on song here in Barbados.
So quick on his feet, and so good an eye, Nick Knight.
100 has come up for England in good time. They would have been very pleased if they'd set out today to say we'd like 100 after 20, and that's almost what they've got. Here's Raoul Lewis. Leg break bowler into the attack for the first time today, who did well in the tournament in Sharjah. And that's as good a thump over extra cover as you'll see. Lewis switching to the tactic I thought he might adopt straight up, which is to come around the wicket to Stewart, try to cramp him a bit and make him hit just one side of the wicket. Wow! Ho-hoo. What a reply!
Oh, smiles all round. He saw Alex Stewart practice that shot on Friday. And he's practiced it pretty well.
Hoop around the wicket. And another Knight boundary. 9 fours and 3 sixes in Nick Knight, 73. Superb batting by Nick Knight. He just seems to look where Lara places the fielders and then hit the ball where they're not.
Well, it's difficult to see how he's going to get a game in this series after this start.
There's 50 for Alex Stewart. It's not often Alex Stewart has to play a second fiddle to an opening batsman. He's had to do that today. Halfway point in the England innings, a tremendous platform to push on towards 300 runs off 50 overs. Magnificent. Just one bounce through extra cover. Yes. There is the 150 partnership. Knight 87 and Stewart 61.
The new record for an opening partnership. Here's the man whose record's just been broken. I don't think he'll mind that at all.
Bowled him out. End of a superb opening partnership. Alex Stewart goes, bowled by Courtney Walsh. It's taken a while for the crowd here to celebrate something. Just clipping the outside of the off stump. Alex Stewart, 74 from just 85 deliveries. He's bowled by Courtney Walsh, England, 165 for one. 31-year-old Graham Hick comes out to join Nick Knight. Hick wants a single, they have to run. Oh. And instead of picking up one, he's picked up five. Nothing going the West Indies' way.
Knight down the pitch. Six. Goodness me. What a way to go to 99 for Nick Knight. Nothing more than a little flick. For Nick Knight of Warwickshire, captain of England A this winter and a crucial member of this impressive England one-day team. Well played.
Well played indeed. An excellent knock.
Good shot. Very good placement by Nick Knight. Full toss it may have been, but he still had to thread it between mid-wicket and mid-on. There was not much of a gap there, and he found it. Another fine stroke. Now, Ambrose has gone seven overs without conceding a boundary. These have been two consecutive fours now. Bold. So Graham Hick trying to hit inside out. Roy Lewis picks him up. England lose their second wicket for 227.
Giving himself room, just not quite to the pitch. And Roy Lewis is delighted with that.
Graham Thorpe now comes out. Confusion, wrong end. Looks close. Umpire Eddie Nichols has called for the replay. All sorts of confusion.
I think Nick Knight knows that he's out here. There was a horrible mix-up between Thorpe and Knight. And he's gone.
Yeah.
And there he goes. Nick Knight has gone. The end of a splendid innings. Run out for 122. England 228 for three.
New batsman is Adam Holyoake. A lot of confusion on this run out. Oh, yes, no, they've grounded there. Then back, yes, yours, mine.
Four. Holyoake off the mark.
Run-out chance. Well, certainly he should have looked at his end.
Well, it's getting all very frenetic out there. Adam Holyoake, I don't think, picked that up. And he set off straight away. Graham Thorpe was well short.
Good shot. That'll go all the way, waited for it. Adam Holyoake puts it away for four.
A good response from Adam Holyoake, picking his gap on the onside.
So Phil Simmons strikes. Graham Thorpe, such a dangerous individual, goes, and the West Indies are pulling things back here, trying to give himself room. Leg stump gone, and England now 249 for four in the 46th over. New batsman is marking them.
It's chipped over extra cover, and that'll roll into that short boundary in front of the Greenwich and Haynes stand. Anything goes now for the England batsmen.
Well, they can well afford to take a few chances at this stage. They're into the last three overs and quite a few wickets still in hand.
It's a big hit. And that's gone all the way. That's a massive hit. That's one of the longer boundaries down there. A rethink for Phil Simmons. He's gone for 10 in two balls. Balls left. Simmons on the mark again, but that's a lovely little cameo from Mark Elam, just what England wanted. 20 quick fire runs, but they've lost their fifth wicket now. Score 271. Kent's Mark Elam replaced by Kent's Matthew Fleming. Very untidy from the home team. There's a problem here for Junior Murray, who had to go charging after that ill-directed throw. There you see Murray just stretching for that ball and then collapsing in a heap, and in a heap of agony too. Stuart Williams comes on as a substitute fielder, but it's Philo Wallace behind the stumps. Got onto that. Chandrapal's dropped it and it's gone over the rope for six runs. Simmons to Fleming, the last ball. Holyoke will be back for the second. And England close. Just seven runs short of 300. 293 for five off their 50 overs.
And that's England's highest score in West Indies in one-day internationals. But the real statistical milestone was that first wicket partnership of 165 between Alex Stewart and Nick Knight. That's a record for the first wicket anywhere between England and West Indies for England in one-day internationals. Nick Knight's 122 came off 130 balls, including four sixes. As for the bowling card, Phil Simmons bowled intelligently there, and Carl Hooper, as usual, was very difficult to get away. Over the past week, they've been celebrating the Barbados Cricket Festival, and the highlight came during the Vice-Chancellor's match on Friday, when two of the greatest West Indian batsmen were honoured for their services to the game. Gordon Greenidge and Desmond Haynes were regarded as the greatest opening partnership ever to play the game. Their contribution was marked by the opening of the new Greenidge and Haynes stand here at the Kensington Oval. And then, to the delight of the local crowd, they opened the batting for the Vice-Chancellor's 11 against England for the very last time. After a nervous start, it didn't take long before they rolled back the years with some typical shots. And once again, they compiled another century partnership to go with the 15 they made in one-day internationals in their heyday. A couple of great West Indian openers there. Now let's see how two of their successors, Philo Wallace and Clayton Lambert, get on in the West Indies reply to England's 293 for five.
So Dougie Brown gets ready for the first ball of the innings. We'll go to Clayton Lambert. The last time he bowled the first ball against the West Indies in Sharjah, he had Philo Wallace out in the first over. That's a pretty good start for the West Indies. Field is fast. Thumping start by Clayton Lambert. There's an individual who used to give the ball a
a fair thump himself, and quite regularly as well, not least on this ground. Viv Richards is over there. There's the explosion, not only from the back, but also from beyond the boundary.
It didn't take very long to that for that ball to get to the fence.
Over the top. Deliberate shot.
It's just the same way that Phil O'Wallace bats in Test match cricket. England shouldn't be surprised by it.
Brilliant save. Magnificently saved by Graham Hick, who has just got into that position. And that is considered a catching position.
Well, one of the highlights of England's play in Sharjah was the brilliant fielding.
Taken. Good catch. So Brown gets his revenge. Phil O'Wallace hit it hard, but hit it straight. And they've got rid of him. Graham Hick has taken the catch. And the West Indies are 25 for one off the fifth ball of the third over.
It's a very important breakthrough for England. A very good catch. The ball hit very hard. But Hick was up to the task. Phil O'Wallace goes for 13. It's 25 for one.
New batsman is the West Indies captain, Brian Lara. Played here on Friday and was run out without facing a ball. Very alert running. Clayton Lambert really has been very impressive since he's come in to the West Indies side. He's a very experienced cricketer, of course. He's been around for a long time. Caught behind. So the two openers gone, one after the other. Wallace and now Lambert caught behind. Had a little bit extra on that from Headley. The 27 for two.
Well, Dean Headley's got some extra pace here, and the ball seamed away. Thick outside edge from Lambert. A good catch by Alex Stewart. Both openers are gone. The West Indies now 27 for two.
New batsman is Carl Hooper, so West Indies having lost both openers very quickly. Really has been quite an extraordinary start.
Characteristic from Carl Hooper. He's always been one of the best players on the offside when hitting the ball in the air. Well, we can just keep saying it. This is one of the great improvisers, one of the great players the game has seen. Cracking stroke, just a touch of width, and Lara cashing in. Exquisite timing, almost as if the ball was drawn into the middle of the bat. Fetch that. Hit with enormous power. No slip, just been taken away. Change in the field because of the stroke before that went for four means that Lara has a vacant area and he's very strong. There was edge in that, but it was deliberate in that area. 57 for two. Incredible ease with which Carl Hooper does everything on a cricket field was on show there.
lot wrong with the delivery. It's just an excellent shot. Gets himself into position and just hoists it over the infield. No need to run for that one.
Even better in its way.
It's one with Brian Lara and Carl Hugo have got a plane to catch. Hanging around.
Cooper's done it again. It's a fruitless chase. We have a change of bowling, Matthew Fleming. And his medium pace is to the delight of Brian Lara. 50 partnership in just over half an hour. Lara's on the pickup and picks up four more. It's pretty hard to bowl at him, I can tell you. Irrepressible stuff, magical to watch.
People facing his Kent teammate, Matthew Fleming. Slower ball. And just wide of cover, it's four more. We've got Croft, the fielder.
This would have to have been a very, very good catch. Diving to his left, just about perhaps getting his fingers to it, but a difficult chance.
Milestone for Carl Hooper. He's got 4,000 runs in one-day international cricket. Only the sixth West Indian to achieve that landmark. Four more. But exquisitely played by Brian Lara. Fine sweep for the medium pace bowler. West Indies are up to 111 for two. I think that might have been a chance. Difficult one. Good over from Elam. West Indies 115 for two. Hooper goes straight down the ground. And he's gone. Caught by Dean Headley, who made good ground to his right. England have worked hard there, tied Hooper and Lara down for a couple of overs, and Hooper's gone.
Well, it's a bit harder to hit over the top once the man is out at long off. You have got to hit it very hard and very far. He didn't hit it far enough. Carl Hooper, Dean Headley taking the catch. West Indies now 115 for three. West Indies not in a very healthy position at the moment, and it could have been worse. Brian Lara was the man on strike in the previous over. Alex Stewart just failing to hold on to that.
Pulled from Lara. And compromising stroke from the West Indies captain takes him to 50.
Good 50 from Brian Lara, but you can see it in his face. He's obviously not very happy. He knows it's a very difficult task to win this game from here.
Chanderpaul on strike now for his first ball. It's got to be close. Got to be close. Basil Morgan says not out. West Indies are 124 for three.
It seems as if Basil Morgan was telling Matt Fleming that it pitched outside leg. Well, it's pretty close. Very close to pitching on leg.
Oh. over the top from Chanderpaul. Not middled, but it's come for four.
That's a huge hit. That is up on the scoreboard. I've watched cricket here for, I reckon, 30, 35 years. I can't remember a ball hitting that high on the scoreboard.
Brian Lara not missing out on that one. And that goes a long way.
Not a day to be a bowler.
Now, this way it should be, I think. Tony Owls feel that the batsman should have the advantage in one-day cricket. Very fine.
Very
shot.
Delicate. Outfield is fast, very fast. Just a nudge from the off-spinner. Not a day to be a bowler, as I said.
Just makes it look so easy, doesn't it, Brian Lara? Just rocks back. Just races away.
Top edge, easy catch, Chanderpaul goes. So Robert Croft in his very first over gets the wicket of Chanderpaul. West Indies lose another one, and in spite of the scoring rate being about 7 and over, they're losing wickets as well.
For the sweep, it was too short to sweep that ball. Bounced a little bit, top edge. McKnight won't get many easier than that. Chanderpaul's gone for 8. West Indies now 145 for 4.
Well struck. Fractionally short and really well put away. So West Indies have raised their 150. The scoring rate now just gone down below 7 runs and over, but the overall rate required is far less than that. It's a question of wickets now. That's gone. Just pitching inside the boundary. Umpire Basil Morgan will ask for the television replay. Might just have carried.
On the fielder is signalling 6. Graham Hick was probably the closest to it, and it was 6 by a couple of inches.
So that West Indies worm beginning just to decline a bit. That'll help it on. Bad delivery down the leg side by Holyoake, and Simmons takes advantage of it.
It's a good hit from Simmons. There's no fielder down long on, and he just dragged it a touch, sort of set himself up to hit it straight, and then just punched the bottom hand in. Adam Holyoake's done it. That's the length that we were talking about. Simmons hitting across the line. He's livid with himself.
Good length again from Holyoake. Dead straight. It's just hurried through on Simmons, who plays an ungainly shot across the line that causes his downfall. Well bowled, England's captain. Simmons has gone for 18. And the West Indies are 187 for 5.
Junior Murray, the new batsman for the West Indies, he's come out with a runner. Carl Hooper is the man who's going to do the job for him. Well, now, Lara was very lazy about the first few strides of that second run. He wasn't sure he was going to take it at first, then he got halfway down the pitch, having decided to go, and accelerated.
Wonder if he's left it too late.
Well, the third umpire is having a look at this.
Matthew Fleming's the fielder with this brilliant return.
Well, it's very close, but I think he's in.
Given in, and rightly so. Little lesson for Lara, though. Never really see Lara struggle. It's just a touch short from Holyoake, and it's about 6 yards over the fence for Lara. Lara goes again. This time it's just four, but it's a real problem for Adam Holyoake. His natural length is being hammered. This is a wonderful batsman at the peak of his power, and he's entertained this enormous crowd at the Kensington Oval quite richly here today. Be gone. Not a clever run. Lara's given himself out.
Ben Holyoake's the fielder. I don't think Lara's going to be close here. Well, you can see that the stumps are broken by Stewart's gloves, and Lara is way short.
Well, Lara's given himself run out, whether or not the red light has shown. It's a dismal end, really, to what has been a marvellous innings, an innings that's getting him a standing ovation and ought to really have gone on to win the West Indies the match. It hasn't. He's gone for 110. It's now 219 for six.
Big shout by Stewart. And given. England on fire here now, seven down the West Indies for 222, and Junior Murray limps off in great pain. It was a brave effort for him to come out and bat, but with Lara and Murray going in quick succession, the match looks like England's.
Well, I think as soon as Lara went, the match certainly had to be England's. Would have been very difficult for Junior Murray to really salvage this game for the West Indies. West Indies really faltering now, just 222 runs on the tins. Quite a few overs to go, but not too many wickets.
Franklin Rose in at number 9, 26 years of age. But you see those white skyscrapers getting smaller and smaller. They'll soon be bungalows. Over. That's the boundary the West Indies are looking for. Comes off the last ball of Headley's eighth over. West Indies 235 for seven. Well, that's a great spell from Robert Croft. It comes to an end with him picking up figures of 1 for 37. The West Indies seven down for 237. Stroke, and Ben Holyoake can't get there. That's the boundary. Terrific over for the home team. 11 runs coming from Holyoake's over, and the 250s up for the West Indies.
And when you play shots like that and they go for four, you may feel the luck is on your side. Beautifully done by Stewart. That is a superb piece of wicket-keeping. He's called for the replay.
It's a full-length ball right up in the block hole. And that is excellent keeping. That is out.
The problem is that the lights are not working, and umpire Basil Morgan has now gone back just to get the confirmation, and he's giving him out. So Lewis goes stumped, and that really was a magnificent piece of wicket-keeping by Alex Stewart. New batsman is Kirtley Ambrose, who isn't entirely in colours. Put it down. That could have been curtains.
Just a slower ball and hit very, very hard. Nothing, almost hanging on to that. That would have been quite a special catch. I think he's quite relieved that it didn't go for two or three runs.
I think to the spirit of this England team, they, even though he's dropped what looks as if it could be a crucial catch, there's smiles all around. That's down the ground, Headley is back, but it's gone. Easy catch, slow ball, what an over that was, a drop catch, a big six, and then a wicket to end it off. 20 needed by the West Indies, and just one wicket now for England.
Brave piece of bowling.
Dropped it. Jumped too early, mistimed the catch. Graham Thorpe in that position. Catch you would expect him to take 9 times out of 10.
Oh, yeah!
That's all over. England have won the match by 16 runs. And what a start we've had to the Cable Wireless One Day Series.
That was a brilliant 100 by Brian Lara, the first time he scored 100 in any form of cricket in Barbados in his career. Another cameo from Carl Hooper, some good batting near the end there by Lewis and Rose. Now the bowling figures. Some clever bowling by Mark Elam, two important wickets there by Matthew Fleming. So England win with just 19 balls to spare, and the man of the match, Nick Knight. But probably the most relieved Englishman on the field was the captain, Adam Holyoake.
293 is usually a pretty good score, but out here it was, you know, a good wicket. And when you've got people like Lara and Hooper in the side, you're always under a bit of pressure. So I'm glad we stuck to it and very happy to go in with the win.
And a special word for Nick Knight?
Yeah, I mean, he batted brilliantly. He's, I think he's got a phenomenal record in one-day cricket and he got us off to a great start.
Don't you ever give your brother a bat or a bowl?
No, I think he has to play his match piece today. I think he's the old club player.
Well, he did run out Brian Lara.
Yeah, that proved to be a big part in the game.
So England go 1-0 up, not without a tremor or two, though. We're back here on Wednesday for the second of the One Day Internationals. Please join us at the Kensington Oval then. From all of us now, good night.
Meet Streetwise director Martin
International. Here's Pat Murphy.